LBJ East in Dallas is one of the most expensive highway projects in America. At nearly $1.74 billion, this 10-mile stretch of Interstate 635 comes in at about $158 million per mile, a staggering figure for any road. And here's the twist. Much of that money depends on tolling, in a state where voters have repeatedly said they don't want toll roads. So why is Texas spending this much? And what does it mean for the millions of people who drive through Dallas every year? Today, we're taking a closer look at the LBJ East project, its history, engineering, challenges, and the future of driving in North Texas. Interstate 635, better known as LBJ Freeway, has been part of Dallas life since the late 1960s. Originally, it was built as a suburban bypass, circling around the growing city. But as Dallas expanded, so did traffic. LBJ quickly turned into one of the most important east-west commuter routes, linking suburbs like Garland, Mesquite, and Lake Highlands with the city's business districts. Over the decades, congestion only got worse. By the 2000s, LBJ East had landed on the list of Texas's top 30 most congested roadways, costing commuters thousands of hours in delays each year. A major fix came in 2015 on the western side of the freeway. The $2.6 billion LBJ Express project added 13 miles of toll lanes and rebuilt interchanges. It helped, but traffic on the east side, where I-635 connects with I-30 and US 80, remained a nightmare. Drivers could spend up to an hour crawling through a stretch that should take 15 minutes. Clearly, something bigger had to be done. That something became LBJ East. In 2019, the Texas Department of Transportation awarded a $1.74 billion contract to Pegasus Link Constructors, a joint venture tasked with designing, building, and maintaining the corridor through 2025. Unlike private toll road deals, TxDOT keeps ownership here and carries the financial risk. Pegasus gets paid based on performance milestones, finish on time, hit quality targets, and they earn their payments. Construction began in spring 2020, staged carefully so traffic could still move. Crews worked from the inside out, first using the medians and shoulders, then shifting cars onto new pavement while older lanes were rebuilt. When finished, the rebuilt LBJ East will feature 5 free lanes in each direction, plus 2 tolled managed lanes running down the middle. Nearly every major interchange, like I-30, Miller Road, and Garland Avenue, has been widened or rebuilt. It's not just a facelift. This is essentially a brand new highway. One of the most striking features is a signature flyover bridge, supported by 2 steel arches rising 60 feet high. This structure helps untangle complex turning movements, reducing dangerous weaving where drivers cut across lanes. To keep local access flowing, the project adds continuous frontage roads on both sides of the freeway. Even when the main lanes back up, drivers will still have reliable ways to move between neighborhoods and businesses. A big part of the strategy is building as much pavement offline as possible, meaning away from existing traffic lanes. That reduces closures and keeps commuters moving, even during major construction phases. Of course, none of this comes cheap. The LBJ East rebuild uses a tolling system that's fully electronic. There are no toll booths. Instead, overhead sensors read license plates or electronic tags. Prices adjust in real time to keep traffic moving at about 50 miles per hour. At launch, tolls are expected to range from 30 to 35 cents per mile. Carpools and transit vehicles get a free pass. Revenue from these tolls helps support other roads in the region. But if toll income falls short, taxpayers pick up the slack. Funding for the project is a complicated mix. About $800 million from state and federal sources, and another $940 million covered through toll-backed financing. A 2018 state ban on new toll roads forced a split approach. Roughly 7.3 miles of the corridor through Garland and Mesquite will be toll-free, while 3.7 miles closer to Dallas will use managed toll lanes. And here's where things get messy. Texans don't like toll roads. In fact, voters have consistently opposed toll-based funding for highways. Many see them as double taxation, paying once through fuel taxes and again through tolls. Costs have also spiraled. The LBJ East project now averages $158 million per mile, far higher than federal benchmarks. Why? Building in the middle of a live freeway requires careful staging, high-performance materials, and extremely complex interchanges. On top of that, inflation and supply chain shortages during the early 2020s added about $5 million per month to expenses. Critics also point to the concept of induced demand. Build more lanes, they argue, and more cars will come, quickly filling up any new capacity. That means congestion relief may only be temporary. Transit is another weak point. While buses can use the express lanes, there are no dedicated bus rapid transit corridors, and the DART light rail system doesn't directly connect to LBJ East. A new commuter service, the Silver Line Rail, is planned, but its stations are far from the freeway, and service will be limited. So, for many commuters, the car remains the only option. Still, supporters argue the project is essential. Dallas-Fort Worth is one of the fastest-growing metro areas in the United States, adding nearly 150,000 new residents every year. Without bigger highways, they say, the region's economy could choke on congestion. The design-build model also means construction is faster. Compared to traditional methods, this approach is saving at least 2 years. And for drivers who can afford tolls, managed lanes provide a guaranteed fast option, even during rush hour. That reliability is valuable for everyone, from business travelers to emergency responders. Construction has been underway for more than 5 years. Originally, the corridor was supposed to wrap up by late 2024. But delays, cost overruns, and weather setbacks have pushed that timeline back. Now, officials expect substantial completion by early 2026. Communication from TxDOT hasn't always been clear, leaving drivers uncertain about when each phase will open. Some new lanes are already in use, but major interchange work is still ongoing. So, what does all this mean? LBJ East is a $1.74 billion rebuild, promising 5 free lanes, 2 managed toll lanes, and a modernized corridor that could finally ease one of Texas's worst traffic bottlenecks. Its biggest hurdle may not be engineering, it's public trust. Texans remain skeptical of tolls, and many wonder if this project will truly deliver long-term relief. But for commuters stuck in daily gridlock, even a little improvement could be life-changing. The question is, will it be enough?